Praise our God. And because of that, amen, amen, because we, amen, and because Pastor Baker held the standard, amen, because the standard was holiness, amen, because on the outside, that same board that's on the baptismal pool downstairs right now was what you saw right above our door, amen, praise our God. High Hope Temple of the Apostolic Doctrinal Faith. Amen. Acts 2:38.
Yes,
amen. Praise our God. And it had the days of the service on it. Amen. Tuesday night,
yes.
Wednesday night, Friday night, and Sunday. Hallelujah. That was too much church for some folks. Amen. Praise our God. But we were there every time. When the doors opened, amen. Praise our God. We were there. Amen. That's how we began to grow. Amen. We grew so that we had to get out of there. We had to put chairs down in the middle of the aisle. Amen. We outgrew that place because the Lord was working mightily. Amen. Praise our God. But I'm ahead of myself because before we could even get into that building, amen. Praise our God. I was in the month of May. Amen. Praise our God. Pastor Baker said he had a dream. Amen. He said, and the Lord told him, amen. Praise our God, to get your best suit, put it on, and go to the doctor's house. So he said, he found this brother named Greg. And Greg was working. Greg used to do the detailing on some of the doctor's cars because he also worked at PRMC. And so when Greg, who knew where the doctors lived, and so after Pastor Baker said, well, he got Greg to drive into the pastor's house. I mean, to the doctor's houses. And so he said, the first doctor that the Lord told him to go to was Dr. Barkovich. He said, go to Dr. Barkovich. And so he went. He said, he knocked on the door, and the lady said, he heard Dr. Barkovich's voice say, who is it? She said, some black guy here, some handsome black man here standing here. He said, that ain't nobody but Baker. Tell him to come on in. And so Elder Baker said, he went on in. He said, he said, at that time, Dr. Barkovich wrote him a check for $5,000. Did you hear what I said, saints? $5,000. The man ain't even opened up his mouth because he said, Dr. Barkovich said, he didn't come for nothing but money. Now, Pastor Baker didn't say nothing about the money.
Right.
But he had already had an unction from the Lord. So when he went to Dr. Barkovich, and before he could leave, he said, Dr. Barkovich got on the horn, on the telephone, and told her, the rest of the doctor friends, he said, Baker's coming and get your checkbook out. Amen. Before that day was over, saints of God, before that day was over, Pastor Baker had $27,000.
Thank you, Jesus.
$27,000. Now, see, he already had that $5,000, but we haven't got to spend that money down because when we beautified the place, we were on E. We were on E. Did you hear what an E means? Anything. Amen. Praise our God. And here you only got 8 folks and you got to pay rent that's $600 a month. And God told this man. Now, I'm telling you what I know. I ain't talking about somebody telling me. I was there.
Come on.
He said, get up and put on your best suit.
Yes.
Get your briefcase.
Come on.
And go to the doctor.
Thank you, Lord.
And that's what he did. And he received. And he received more static. Here comes some more opposition. More static trying to put the $27,000 in the bank than he did from getting it. Here's a black man showing up with $27,000 in checks from doctors. This is in 1992. What is this? We're going to make some phone calls here. Do you hear what I'm saying? It took more to get the money in the bank than it did to get it. He had to prove that, that he got it legitimately.
Come on, thank you.
Amen. Praise our God. Hey, the devil don't care how he stops you,
as
long as he can stop you, see?
Yes.
And so the thing of it is, after they had proved that it was legit, amen, praise our God.
Yes.
And so then they accepted it, amen, praise God. Plus the fact, they didn't say nothing about the fact that he had already had $5,000 in the bank. Amen. But when he had $27,000, this is cause for alarm here. Amen. Praise our God. But the fact of it is, we are going to come up against some things. Amen. It might be petty right now. Amen. We can look back and say, it was petty. Amen. But it was a major thing. Here we were trying to find a place to do what? To worship.
Right.
We were trying to find a place, amen, to that these eight souls could have rest. And now 11 souls. Amen. And then we looked up, praise our God, and here comes Sister Carlton. Now it's 12 of us. Sister Evangelist Tull and Deacon Tull.
Yes.
Amen. Praise our God. Now it's 13. Right. And before you know it, amen. See, the first day, which was the 7th of the 7th of June, amen, was Pentecost Sunday. Pentecost Sunday. What an audacious day that was. The day that the Holy Ghost fell, that was our first day in church.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Praise our God. And the second week is when Pastor preached his first sermon. The third week is when Pastor Todd, but Brother Todd and his wife came showing up. Amen. Praise our God. And they ran, and Sister Todd ran into, amen, praise our God, Sister Robinson, amen. And she found out that she was from Connecticut, amen. And it was a kindred spirit because of the saints of God of Emmanuel, amen, going up and down the highway from Connecticut and everywhere else. There were some saints of God that, praise our God, and that connection ain't been disconnected even till now. Amen, praise our God. But we thank God, amen, praise our God, because of how it was. Amen, because of that sign. Amen, praise our God. Talking about the apostolic doctrine of faith. Amen, Acts 2:38. He ain't talking about shaking nobody's hand. Amen, he ain't talking about standing up and saying a sinner's prayer. Amen, because there ain't no such thing. Everybody who prays is a sinner if you ain't saved.
Come on now.
Amen. It doesn't mean you're saved.
All right.
Praise our God. And so we thank God, amen, as they begin to come. Praise our God. We looked up and here comes Brother Townsend with Sister Townsend and their five daughters. Amen. Praise our God. Amen. They were just coming. They were coming. They were coming. Praise our God. At the place, I'm telling you, and then they begin to come out of Berlin. Amen. Praise our God. They begin to come. Amen, praise our God. And it was amazing because that was it. We started off on the 7th of June, 1992. The next month was July, and the July council setting at PAW was about, and Pastor Baker was now going to be ordained. Amen, and we were privileged to see him ordained. Amen, and then came December, amen, when he was installed. We again were privileged to see him, amen, installed as the pastor of Greater, of just the Higher Hope Temple at that time. We had not yet gone to the greater part yet. Praise our God. But the fact of it is, amen, praise our God, we were just growing by leaps and bounds. Amen, praise our God. Looked like, amen, every time we turned around, the saints were coming in. The service was so high, amen, praise our God. We didn't even have sense enough to know what was going on. The thing about it, we had the air conditioner on, praise our God, and we had the heat on. And we'd be in there, the praise would get so high in there till the lights would go out. Amen, praise our God. We didn't know what we was doing.
Right.
Amen, we were wondering. Amen, it's a wonder the place didn't catch on fire. Amen, praise our God. We were like, and listen, I'm telling you, we would close down the place and the saints would be shouting in the driveway. I'm telling you, the service was so high. Amen. People didn't even have the Holy Ghost for shouting. That's why I know you don't have to have the Holy Ghost to shout. I mean, folks didn't have the Holy Ghost, and they were just shouting on down. Everybody was jumping the can on. I just looked at that. You know, some people, you look at them, you say, oh, they're shouting. They got the Holy Ghost. Oh, no. Because the folks ain't still got it to this day. I know them. You all know them, too. But that's another case. Amen, praise our God. But I'm telling you, amen, praise our God. We, amen, praise our God. We had such, not a reputation, but we had such love there at the church, amen, praise our God. I mean, it was just one thing after the other.
Yes, it was.
Praise our God. And we're talking about Pastor Baker, and then we're going to get up talking about our pastor today, Pastor Albert L. Todd. Amen, praise our God, because he was raised in this thing. Amen. Brought up. Amen. Praise our God. He might have did his basic training in Connecticut. Amen. Praise our God. But he went to his main station was Higher Hope Temple in Salisbury, Maryland. Amen. Where he grew up. Amen. Under the direction of District Elder, Pastor Baker, whatever you want to call him, Bishop, Suffering and Bishop Baker. Amen. And we, amen, praise our God. Like I said, we didn't just come. See, now we come Tuesday, and Wednesday, some of us have come Sunday. We were coming Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday. And if we had a special service, we'd come on Friday and Saturday. Amen. Praise the Lord God. We were always in church. The folks across the hall, there was a Reuben house called. Amen. Praise our God. The spirit was so high one day, amen, Deacon Brown had to put the little white guy out. He thought he could just come over there with his guitar and start playing. No, you can't come in here like this. Yeah, he come across the street, boy, he thought he was coming over there to jam. Amen. And Deacon Brown said, no, you can't do that. Praise our God. But they would stand outside and look. We had beautiful big windows, amen, praise God. We had the Venetian blinds over there. Sometimes we could lift them up, amen, so the folks could see the service going on and look at the beauty in the temple that was there, amen, praise our God. We thank God, amen, praise our God, because, amen, it was just, I'm telling you, my wife had some pictures that she had taken, because many times when there was a baptism, amen, Brother Todd at that time would hand them off to me. In the pool. We had some steps that you walk up into, and he let you down in there into the pool. The pool was so big. It was like the thing that you have outside in people's backyards right now. And Elder Robert Fuchs, he brought it over with his truck. He brought it over and donated it to us, and we didn't make him shame. Amen. Praise our God. We used that thing. Praise our God. And we, amen, praise our God. And we always, amen, we were always washing baptismal clothes. We had robes at that time. Man, when you got in the water with that robe on, it was so heavy you couldn't hardly get out. Sister Baker had made them over there, did his head, amen, praise the Lord. It felt like a steel curtain on you, amen, when you try to get out the water. Amen, praise our God. And I would be down in that pool, brother, amen, praise our God. We were baptizing them. The people thought they were going to swim in it. Sometimes, you know how folks, after a while, they get to shouting in the pool? They have plenty of room to shout. Just shout on over there. Bring the next one in. We let them go. I'm telling you, those were the days. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Not that we ain't happy for the days of today. But amen. Praise the Lord God. Everything was new then. All this was a new experience. Everything with God was new to us in his totality. Amen. Because he was doing stuff that we didn't even know existed. I know I didn't know existed. Amen. Praise our God. He was bringing people in. Amen. Praise our God. And the fact about it, the brother Greg, the one, same one, amen, praise our God, that was taking brother Elder Baker to the doctor's house. Amen. Later on, amen, he was the first person that was baptized in the pool. The first person that was baptized in the pool, he was going to a Methodist church. But the fact of it is that he began to really befriend Elder Baker by Elder Baker going with him to the different houses of the doctors. And so he began to come to High Hope Temple. And he was the first one. He has now passed, amen, but he was the first soul that went down in Jesus' name in the pool there at High Hope Temple at 615 South Division Street. Amen. Praise our God. And the thing that really brought tears, amen, I've never told Elder Todd this, but Elder Baker was so moved. Amen. Praise our God. Because it was one thing about, you know, it's something about saying something over somebody when they're stretched out. But when they're standing, sometimes it's embarrassing. Amen. Praise our God. I came one Tuesday night. In fact, it was Bible study night, and I was just there ahead of other people. And Elder Baker told me, I said, what's the matter? And he had tears in his eyes. I said, what's the matter? He said, you know that new couple? I said, the people from Connecticut? He said, yeah. He said, you know that they wrote a check for $500 to this ministry. And we have always heard, and I've always put this together. Do you ever remember Pastor Todd talking about how much he was in debt for having his visitation going back and forth from the base to Connecticut while he was courting Sister Todd. Now, out of, see, he gave out of his, they gave out